Hey everyone, it's that day. It is the weight and measurement update, and this is for week 9. And so this week, like last month around this time, was a hard week. Hard week of cravings, putting in a lot of extra hours, and with work and that kind of thing. And so I think I missed Saturday's workout in one day last week. Okay, and then my eating was probably more around 2,000 calories when I was maintaining around 1,500, just because I was really struggling with controlling those cravings and that sort of thing. I tried, but it's just so hard. And then like a day like today, I felt a little down, like not like down and like as unhappy or anything, just didn't feel as well, felt kind of nauseated for most of the day. And so starting to feel a little bit better. And well, I got week 9 results. Oh, and then here in a second, I'm gonna show you a couple different new workout videos that I got yesterday. And I did a couple of those last night. So actually, if we can go over what I ended up doing Sunday. So since I missed Saturday's workout, I did like target toner. So I did lower and upper body, the Denise Austin workout. And that's about 40 minutes, just that workout, as I did all levels of it. And then I did 20 minutes on the T-Zone program 3. And then I did the 20-minute Zumba. And so that was a pretty good workout. I did 1 hour and 20 minutes trying to make up for Saturday. So that said, I guess we'll go ahead and get into the measurements. I'll get that all done and then I'll come. Okay, so let's get right into the results. I just got them. Okay. And so this is week 9's results. Some pretty good news. I'll tell you what happened with the weight in just a minute. But I have really great news here. So I lost another 1/4 inch off of the chest. My waist stayed the same. So that's now 2 weeks of the waist staying the same. So I have to trim that sucker down, but that's part of that eating issue. My hips, remember how stubborn they've been so far the whole entire time of this journey? Finally, I lost 1/4 inch. So that's a big deal. My left thigh was down 1/4. The right thigh stayed the same. And my left and my right arm stayed the same. So left calf and right calf both down 1/4. So my total inches lost for this past week, it's been 1.5 inches. So the Zumba and stuff is helping there. Definitely will say that. So then let's go on to the weight. So how do you guys think I did with my struggle this week? Do you think I lost weight or did I gain weight? Where did I end up? And I'm telling you, it was a really, really tough week. No joke. But here it is. So remember, I lost 1.5 inches. And my whole journey, I pretty much lost weight that equals how many inches I've lost as well. This week is a little bizarre. I gained 1.6 pounds. But I'll take the inches lost, because that's where it really matters. And this is just whatever weight it is. I'm gonna write off as water. Might be fat. But I'm not gonna let that get me down, because I lost 1.5 inches. And that matters more to me than the weight. So I'm very excited about that. That is really great news. like super great news. And I'm gonna go over real quick with you two videos I just bought. I actually bought four. I went to one of our like our local, you know, video places that sells video games and movies, that kind of thing. I got a couple of these for a pretty great deal. And I will tell you, I was sweating really good yesterday. And sorry for the noise in the background, but you know, it's like freezing here in 1 minute, and today we actually are under tornado watches. Unbelievable. At least, yeah. So, it's pretty warm outside, which means it's really warm in here, and I'm getting ready to do my workout. No, because yesterday, when I did these workouts, I mean, I was sweating really, really good. So I did drop it in 30. I think it's actually a 20-minute workout that's cardio. It was actually good and nice, and this is Prevention Fitness Systems Drop It in 30 with Chris Freitag, and I actually enjoyed it, and she was easy to follow, and I could do the exercises. That's a really big piece to it. And then I got this Trudy Tyler's Weight Loss Yoga, because I feel like I really need to start stretching out my muscles more. And I meant to take my Pilates DVD and get it fixed, but I forgot it. But anyways, this is 20-minute workout too. I did the weight loss one, the weight loss yoga conditioning for weight loss. And it's pretty good, and I don't normally associate sweating with yoga. Yeah, it's great though. I could feel it really helping my back. My lower back, to parts of my mid back, oh, I was feeling that, and I think that will only make my back get better by doing this. So I'm not gonna do these today. I got a couple other ones, and I might try those today. I have to keep the variety, in case you haven't noticed, like, I have to keep trying new things. I'll get bored with it. And that's the key for me to stay on track. Another thing was, I was thinking about the other day, this is one of them. I have the other one actually in my car. I always keep it on me. But you know, I've been reading you some Florence Scovel's Chin chapters. Well, I was thinking about this book, which is The Power of the Spoken Word. And another great book, but it's really funny how these books are so little. Like, this one is a whopping 65 pages, but there again, another thing I love about them is they are compartmentalized. I mean, where I can just take pieces of the book, and that to me is like so incredibly valuable. You know, I love that. So that way you can just go to a story. So stay tuned. I'm gonna pick one out of this one today. Yeah. The Power of the Spoken Word. And then it says up here in the top right-hand corner, if you see it, I have weapons ye know not of. wow. 1930s author and fantastic. I love her work. So anyways, I'll get everything set up and we'll get to the workout. I'm back. And so the workout I think I'm going to do, this is one of my other new DVDs. It is the country, Dance Off the Inches Country Line Dance. You know, the other one I had that I did the other day was, it's not right there, was Hip Off, Dance Off the Inches Hip Hop. And so, have a blast. While you blast off calories. And since I'm feeling a little, you know, hopefully this won't be so bad. I felt like if I did a whole lot of bending, I don't know how that's gonna go. Just feel kind of yucky. It's just one of those blah kind of days. So let's get to it. I'll pop it in and get it all set up and get to the workout.
Thank you.
Okay, so I was doing the country dance off, just to kind of give you an update. And then I got interrupted. I had to go do something real quick. And then I came back and I thought I paused it, but I didn't. And it was so far and yeah, I couldn't do it. So anyways, I did the drop it in 30 prevention, the metabolism workout, and I haven't done that one yet. And I was in the very last set and then I got stuck. So, go ahead. I mean, it's getting late, but I'm going to go ahead and get on the T-Zone. And the story that I have for today is the power of the spoken word in nothing be anxious. I think this will be a good one not only for myself, but for all of you out there at any time that you have great anxiety. And that kind of thing. I think this story is a good one for it. And this is a little bit different. The stories are a little bit different from The Secret Door to Success. Just a little bit. And nonetheless, they're really great. And so, I really appreciate the ones y'all liking the last video I did about Is Your Oil Lamp Full? And also thank you for letting me know your kingpins. It's always helpful, and you know, it's always good for us to identify those, because we can't grow if we're first not aware. So anyways, let's get on to this story, and I'm gonna do the T-Zone Pi program 2 or 3. Basically, I'll make that decision here in just a second. Program 2. Alright, in nothing be anxious. It says all through the Bible we are told not to be anxious, not to be fearful, not to hoard or save, because an invisible power is at man's command to supply every need. But we were told that it would not work unless we believed in it. If thou canst believe in God power, all things are then possible. It is difficult for man to believe in this power because he has had a right training in unbelief. I'll believe only what I can see, was supposed to be the height of wisdom. We lived in the world of externals, where we thought everything just happened. We did not know that back of every happening was a cause that we ourselves started in motion. Let me back that up. We lived in a world of externals where we thought everything just happened. We did not know that back of every happening was a cause that we ourselves started in motion. The machinery which produced good or evil in our pathway. We did not know that words and thoughts are a form of dynamite and should be handled carefully with wisdom and understanding. We hurled out into the ethers words of anger, resentment, or self-pity, then wondered why life was so hard. Why not experiment with faith? Trust this invisible God power and in nothing be anxious, but in everything by prayer and thanksgiving. Let your request be made known unto God. Could anything be more simple or direct? Anxiety and habit have become habits. Anxiety and habit have become habits. The old thought forms you have built up in the subconscious hang on like barnacles on an ocean liner. But the ocean liner is put in dry dock once in a while to have the barnacles scraped off. So your mental barnacles will have to go through the same process. The dry dock is a big situation. I know of a woman who had been a coward all of her life, particularly about finances. She worried all the time about money. She came into this truth, realized how she had limited herself, and suddenly made the giant swing into faith. She commenced to trust God and not the external for her supply. She followed her intuitive leads about spending If any of her clothes made her feel poor, she would discard them at once, getting something new to make her feel rich. She had very little money, but gave one-tenth, a tithe, to good works. She was winding herself into a new vibration. Very soon, things commenced to change on the external. A woman on whom she had no claim, who was merely an old friend of her family, left her $1,000. A few months later, another $1,000 came in. Then a big door opened for her supply, and many thousands came in. She had tapped her invisible supply from the bank of the universal. She had looked to God only for her supply. Then the channels opened. The point I am bringing out is that she had lost all anxiety about money matters. She had established in her subconscious the firm conviction that her supply came from God and it never failed. Man is an instrument for infinite intelligence to work through. It will express through him as success, happiness, abundance, health, and perfect self-expression unless fear and anxiety make a short circuit. If we want examples of fearless faith, go to the circus. The circus people perform seemingly impossible feats because they think they can and see themselves doing it. Faith means that you can see yourself receiving all these things that you desire. I will give to thee the land that thou seest. You can never do a thing you cannot see yourself, or fill a place you cannot see yourself filling. Not visualizing, making a mental picture. This is a mental process and often brings wrong and limited results. It must be a spiritual realization and a feeling that you are already there. Be in its vibration. I was very much impressed with the story of a great football player who was the greatest all-around athlete in the world, who trained in a hammock. One day he was lying there drowsing in the sun, and the trainer came up him with tears streaming down his face and said, "Jim, for the love of Mike and your country, won't you get up out of that hammock and do something?" Jim opened one eye and said, "I was just thinking about that. I was going to send for you." "Good," said the trainer. "What do you want me to do?" "First," said Jim, "I want you to mark off 25 feet there on the ground." The trainer did so. "Then what?" said the trainer. "That's all," said Jim, and he closed his eyes and swung happily. After at least 5 minutes, he opened them and looked at the marks for a few seconds and then closed his eyes again. "What's the idea?" yelled the trainer. "What are you doing?" Jim looked at him reproachfully and replied, "I'm practicing the broad jump." He did all his training in a hammock, seeing himself doing the broad jump. And this is actually true to this day. There's a lot of life coaches out there, not necessarily just the athletic coach, that a lot of professional athletes seek out. And they teach them this very type of training, where you visualize yourself accomplishing the move, and your results of accomplishing that move or those plays have a lot higher percentage rate of accomplishment. So it is factual. And if you were to practice this yourself, you may find some amazing results. Without the vision, my people perish in lack and limitation. You may work very hard on the external and accomplish nothing. If you are without vision, vision means to see clearly where you are going, to keep your eye on the goal. All men who have accomplished big things have done this. James J. Hill, who built the Great Northern Railroad, said, "Before a rail was laid, he heard with his inner ear the rumble of trains and the whistle of the engines." He had many obstacles to overcome, but his vision was so clear it possessed him. One thing in his favor was that his wife believed in him. It is said that it takes two to make a dream come true. Henry Ford, speaking of his mother-in-law, said, "She was a fine woman. She believed in me. When two of you agree, it shall be done. If you believe in yourself, others will believe in you. As you believe in yourself and the God power within, fear and anxiety drop away. You establish the vibration of assurance. This is true of an intuitive person. Every move is made under divine guidance, and he never violates a hunch, therefore he is always given the right place at the right time. However, it often takes great courage to follow intuition. It takes a Viking who is unafraid to sail into unknown seas. Claude Bragdon says, "To live intuitively is to live fourth dimensionally. The magic path leads you to out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. It is invaluable in business. Never submit a hunch to someone on the reasoning plane. Those who have ears to hear, let them hear their intuitive leads and give instant obedience. Whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it to thee. This is true of each one. But if we have not received all the blessings of life, we have neglected to ask, or have not asked all right. The Bible is teaching spiritual law, and we must study and use it from every angle in order to set the great machinery of asking and receiving in motion. Every machine must be greased and oiled to be kept in good working order. Active faith and expectancy keep the machine of asking and receiving in perfect order. The following are some of the lubricants which keep it working. When ye pray, believe ye have it. In nothing be anxious. Stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord. Do not limit the Holy One of Israel. Realization is manifestation. Pray with praise and thanksgiving. Some people pray filled with anger and resentment. A woman wrote to me the other day saying, I have just had a good talk with God and told him just what he ought to do about it. She was in the habit of ordering people around and looked upon God as someone she could bully into doing something for her. God is the supreme intelligence which within each one of us, and we are the channels for it to express itself. We must be non-resistant, poised and peaceful, expecting our good to come to pass. We are the receivers, God is the giver, and he must create his own channels. We find there is quite an art in praying, all right? God must have right of way, his way, not your way. The moment you make your demand, infinite intelligence knows the way of fulfillment. If you decide how your prayer shall be answered, you have blocked the divinely designed channel. Then you are apt to say, I never have my prayers answered. We must acquire a technique and send out a sincere desire, which is prayer. We are free from all clutch or anxiety when we say, if this is according to the divine plan, we will receive it. If not, give us its equivalent. Be careful not to force anything not divinely planned. We must know that linked with God power, nothing can defeat us. God's ways are ingenious. His methods are sure. Two of the most beautiful psalms are the 23rd and the 121st. Both give one a feeling of absolute security and were written by a man who had experienced the working of spiritual law. The God within protects, guides, and provides when fully trusted. Most people lose what they love, most through fear of loss. They take every precaution on the external, not trusting the protection to the eye which watches over Israel. Put whatever you love under the law of the divine protection. The most important part of demonstrating is showing fearless faith. I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut slender the bars of iron. The Bible is talking about states of consciousness. The gates of brass and bars of iron are your doubts, fears, resentments, and anxieties. The gates of brass and bars of iron are of our own making and come from our own vain imaginings, a belief in evil. There is a story of a herd of wild elephants. They were corralled in an enclosure, but the man had no way of keeping them in, so they dug stakes and put a rope around the enclosure. The elephants thought they could not get out. They have just walked over the rope and stepped out, but they had the illusion that the rope kept them in. This is the way with people. Doubt and fear is a rope stretched around their consciousness. It makes it impossible for them to walk out into clear thinking. Clear vision is like a man with a compass. He knows where he is going. Let intuition be your compass, and it will always get you out of the woods. Even a man without a compass led by intuition would find his way out of the jungle or be able to steer a ship at sea. Intuition will tell you to walk over the rope. It is amazing how people have overlooked their most important faculty, intuition. Always on a man's pathway is his message or lead. Often our leads seem trivial and silly. A person purely on the intellectual plane would dismiss them at once, but the true student always has a spiritual ear to the spiritual ground, knowing he is receiving orders from the infinite. The Bible speaks often of the still small voice. It is a voice which is not an actual voice, though sometimes actual words are registered on the inner ear. When we ask for guidance and lay aside the reasoning mind, we are tapping the universal supply of all knowledge. Anything necessary for you to know will be revealed to you. Some people are naturally intuitive and are always in contact with universal intelligence, but by taking an affirmation, we make a conscious contact. Prayer is telephoning to God, and intuition is when God telephones and they don't get the message. Your wire is busy when you are discouraged, angry, or resentful. You've heard the expression, "I was so mad I couldn't see straight." We might add, "I was so mad I couldn't hear straight." Your negative emotions drown out the voice of intuition. When you are discouraged, angry, or resentful, is the time to make a statement of truth. In order to get out of the woods of despair and limitation, for whosoever calleth on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. There is a way out. Reveal to me the way. We must stop planning, plotting, and scheming, and let infinite intelligence solve the problem in its own way. God power is subtle, silent, and irresistible. It levels mountains and fills in valleys and knows no defeat. Our part is to prepare for our blessings and follow our intuitive leads. We now give infinite intelligence a right away. So if there is something that you have been maybe fearful of or have great anxiety of that keeps you away from doing things that you want to do, maybe in your career, your home life, whatever it is, your personal goals, you know, denounce it, whatever. But it is a choice, and you're going to have to be sincere about it. But I do want to thank you for taking the time out of your busy day to join me on my journey and to stick around and listen to the reading from The Power of the Spoken Word, Florence Scovel Shinn. And Nothing Be Anxious, I believe that's what it was. Another great story. You know, I'll share some other ones with you. If you guys like it, just let me know. I really appreciate the opportunity to be able to share with you this valuable information. And I hope you all take care and have a lovely rest of the week. See you next time. Bye-bye.